Karina.
Oh, yan na nga. Kasi meron tayo ulit kasama ngayong Monday. Yung sinabi ko nga kanina, si Ms. Sheila Viesca, Personal Effectiveness Coach and Corporate Communications Guru. Good morning sa'yo.
Good morning, Ms. Sheila.
Alam mo naman, pag Monday, the time of the day, na magkukwentuhan tayo mga girls here.
Yes.
Ano ba pag-uusapan natin, Ms. Sheila?
Well, another light and sensible topic, friendly persuasion.
Yes.
Wow. Yes. How to get the things you want and need.
Oh, ni kanina pag-uusapan nga namin yan nila Kike, di ba? Pagdating sa mga binibili, may reminder lagi na,
buy diba? What you need.
Do I need this? Yeah,
do I need this?
Or do I just want it? Yung mga ganon. Tama po.
Yes, tama. Unfortunately, for females, generally, we cannot differentiate. If we want it, we create the need for it.
Totoo ka dyan. Kasi minsan, kunyari, may nakita ka, tapos medyo yung price, diba? Tapos sabihin mo, do I want it? Do I want it? Sabi ko na, well, you never know. Diba?
Maybe in the future.
Kailan ko siya kakailanganin. At least, nandiyan na.
Para sa akin, best to get it. Para sa akin, yung asawa ko yung ganyan. Kasi graduate na ako dun. Sa naman ngayon, nagbo-bloom.
Oo, may aversion na tayo dun.
Ano nga ba yung approach sa ganun? How do you weigh things? Kung kailangan mo ba o gusto mo lang?
Well, if it is a matter of life and death, your health,
grabe naman.
Personal well-being, that's a need.
Uh-oh.
If it is just something that you desire, kasi cute siya, nagandahan ka, at the moment, it makes you happy.
Still
pero hindi mo naman ikalulungkot or hindi naman malaking kawalan, that's definitely a want.
A want.
Something that you desire.
So, yung halimbawa, yung kunyari, may nakita ka sa shopping, tapos umuwi ka na, hindi mo binili, hindi ka makatulog. Sabi, pag hindi ka daw makatulog, bilhin mo na eh.
Para matahimik ka na daw.
One pa rin yun.
Oo, that's a good measure. Pag alam mong sobrang dami mo nang nabiling sapatos, tapos pareho lang yung design, pareho lang yung kulay, pero talagang you feel the need for this one. Kasi iba naman yung pagkaka-ribbon.
Di, tsaka baka kasi sobrang favorite mo, pag nasira, wala ka na mabili. Bili ka na madami.
Itulog mo muna, then the following day, if you still feel the need to buy it at magkakasakit ka, edi,
bili
mo na. It's affecting your well-being, di ba? Your sense of focus.
Yung iba naman sasabihin, sige, sige, bilhin mo na. Hindi, pag bumalik tayo dito at nandyan pa, bibilin ko.
Meant to be.
Pero kinabukasan, bumalik. Binili. Kasi bumalik eh.
Oo, nandyan pa eh. And at saka pag sinabing, kasi may discount.
Oh,
saka, 6 months to pay, zero interest.
Totoo. And that's when we can relate that to persuasion. How do we persuade others? How do we create this process? When they feel that something that they actually just want is a need that they have to invest in. And persuasion, if it's done right, can make us more effective in the workplace and in our relationships.
Mm-hmm.
Ang usual comparison is, what is persuasion and how does it differ from motivation?
Mm-hmm.
Yung persuasion kasi, it's the process that the person goes through. While motivation requires a compelling reason.
Mm-hmm.
Na yun nga nangyayari. If you create in your mind that this compelling reason is going to make a big difference in your life, bibilin mo yun. So whoever is in that position to persuade another person should strongly consider the concern of the target audience. Ano yung context at sino yung kinakausap mo, sino yung binibenta.
Hindi yung basta makakontra ka lang na huwag mo bilhin yan, di mo naman kailangan yan. So dapat i-consider niya muna kung halimbawa ikaw, gusto mong bilhin to, bakit mo gustong bilhin?
Mm-hmm.
Paglalaanan ka ba niyan? Diba, para kanino ba yan? Yung mga ganon.
Yeah. And we tend to make things complicated but they're actually very simple.
Mm-hmm.
May pera ka bang pambili? Una-una. Makakabuti ba to sa budget mo?
Totoo.
And then, yung sasabihin ng mga tao? Ano mararamdaman mo sa pagtulog mo? So, basic questions, basic sensibilities have to be answered.
Mm-hmm.
And as important as your consideration is the call of the moment. Kung ano nga yung budget na nakalaan para dun sa bagay na yon. Now, when it comes to relationships, kasi yung persuasion is something that we normally apply to persuade people so that they can be on our side. Mm. We can so that we can broaden our circle of influence. Ang mga consideration mo dyan, likability. You cannot persuade if people don't like you. Pag nakita mo yung isang bagay, gusto mo. Right? Mm. You don't have to justify it in your mind kasi gusto mo yung kulay, gusto mo yung design. Mm-hmm. Similarly, when we want to persuade anyone, kailangan gusto nila yung naririnig nila sa'yo. Mm-hmm. So you have to consider what's important to them and what their priorities are. And align the message to that.
Kasi believe it or not, di ba Miss Sheila, hindi lahat ng tao magaling sa pag-persuade.
Yes.
Di ba? Kaya nga minsan may makikita ka dun sa... May makikita sa mga books to The Power of Persuasion, yung mga ganyan. Kasi hindi talaga lahat, kahit anong gawin mo, kahit magbale-balentong ka dyan eh, hindi pa rin maniniwala sa, or hindi pa rin siya...
Good point. Convincing.
Hindi mako-convince.
Well, those who have mastered it know that one surefire formula to persuade anyone is to create indebtedness. So whether it's in the form of a compliment or a gift, or a kind gesture, you make the other person feel indebted na medyo mahirap na siyang humindi sa'yo. Of course, it has to be done with sincerity. Kasi kung bola lang yan, di ba, or superficial lang,
user
or fake yung assistance, yes, it can definitely backfire, do more harm than
so
good.
So we're talking about, 48 laws of power, di ba? Kasi, bawa, meron akong gustong ibigay sa'yo. Diba? Meron akong ano para in the future pwede kitang mahinga ng favor. Na parang pino-persuade kita on my side.
Yes.
Diba? Ganon.
Our consideration here is that everyone is tuned to his own channel. What's in it for me? So whether you are a speaker or a leader, a store manager, kung ano yung sasabihin mo is as important as the consideration of the person you're talking to. Kung hindi siya relevant at hindi siya relatable, and you are not able to establish rapport kasi tama yung sinasabi mo pero mali yung pagkakasabi, then it's very difficult to convince anyone. So
ano yung technique na para kasi minsan talaga may isang tao matigas ulo hindi mo mapapersuade yan. Like for example, di ba yung mga in-example natin kanina tungkol sa pagbili etc. Talagang fix na focus na siya yung mind niya na bibilin ko to whether I need it or I just want it. And ikaw bilang concern, kunyari kaibigan ka or workmate etc, di ba? Paano mo mapapersuade yun ng walang alam mo yung ma-offend, walang mag-aaway, walang mag-argue.
Diyan papasok yung choose your battle.
Choose your battle.
Kasi kung may budget naman siya at hindi mo naman pera yung gagastusin niya.
Wapakel.
At ikaliligaya naman niya yun.
Ngingi lang.
Who are you to get
pero
in the
Sheila,
way?
What if right? Itong kakilala mong to may tendency maging hoarder? Yung tipo okay bibilin niya. Magagamit niya siguro once, twice. Pero to the point na para ang dami-dami na mga stock na ganun, dami-dami niya na ganun sa bahay, hindi naman pinakikinabangan. How do you address someone like that? Paano mo ba pakikitunguhan yun? Kasi concerned ka na gusto mo talagang tulungan.
Communicating sincerely is very important. Kailangan malaman ng tao kung ano yung... kasi normally, it's very difficult to function within our own frame. We need someone to intervene. Someone who's looking from outside the box, who can make us see the big picture. And it's not possible kung magkakaroon ka lang ng mentality of blame. Diba? Sisi ka ng sisi o kaya susumbatan mo yung tao. You have to give the pros and cons. Kailangan maipaalala mo sa kanya. Minsan, impulsive buying na lang.
Yes.
Nakakalimutan natin, may ganun pala tayong item. So, a friendly reminder will help greatly. But definitely, that person has to be convinced himself. It's a personal decision that person has to make para ma-cure niya yung tendency niya na mag-hoard. The real help will not be coming from the outside.
But dun sa aspect naman na kanina pinag-uusapan natin, yung sa yung friendly persuasion, yung para makuha mo yung isang tao on your side, 'di ba? Parang how would you know if that person is already manipulating you? 'Di ba? Hindi na friendly persuasion yung ginagawa niya.
Oh, you have to be able to ask yourself why this person is communicating with me in the first place. Kasi ang operational thinking naman natin is, what's in it for me?
Mamaya may ulterior motive para doon, diba? Bigay ng bigay, or kasi gusto niyang yung person na yan will be doon sa team niya or whatever. In a corporate setup, ah.
Oo. Sometimes it's hard to detect kasi may mga tao na magaling talagang mag-convince. And you have to deliberate and not be reactive in responding or in giving your answers. Maghintay ka muna. We tend to feel that we have to say yes right away, or we have to give an answer right away. But give your moment that moment to step back and analyze where this person is coming from. And that way, makikita mo if it's friendly persuasion and it's going to be a win-win situation, or namamanipulate ka lang into thinking or doing something that will work for him or her and not for you.
Mm, parang in the end, ginagamit ka lang pala niya para sa mga gusto niya, hindi sa pangangailangan niya.
Yeah. Ultimately, this process is something that that we master through practice. Kaya lang, hindi natin matatanggal na may mga tao magaling mag-persuade even if they have the wrong intentions. Right? And someone who thinks clearly and who has all the right intentions should also know the process. Ang proseso niya mag-uumpisa sa'yo. You have to think positive about how you feel about certain things and how you feel about certain situations. You have to be happy with who you are. You have to feel complete. Kasi if that's not the case, anyone can convince you to think about anything. Kasi wala kang ang self-assurance that you're good enough or that your decision is good enough. Then, simplify. Huwag mo masyadong i-overwhelm yung sarili mo. Marami kang maririnig. But what do you actually want and what do you actually need? Ano yung makakasaya sa'yo? And considering the big picture and the long-term plans, ano yung makakabuti para sa sitwasyon? Then, in the end, it's the character that you build. We always talk about this. Mm-hmm. When you use persuasion on anyone, what kind of person does it make you? Kasi when you persuade, you consider that there's something good that you're bringing to the table. You're adding value to the situation. If that's not the case, medyo isipin muna kung ano yung ino-offer mo. And in running a business, in conducting your life, in building relationships, you have to give more than what you're expecting to receive. And that's when any kind of engagement becomes productive. So as we consider this, ano ba yung gusto ng tao? Ano yung kailangan niya? If you can address any of them and then persuade him into getting on your side or buying your service or products, maganda.
Di parang at the end of the day, isipin mo na lang, Michelle, ano ba talaga yung end goal mo in doing this?
Yeah.
Kasi otherwise, kung nagsasaya lang tayo ng oras.
Yes.
Diba?
Ano yung end goal mo? And does that end goal connect to the goals of the persons you're talking to? Kasi ang ultimate secret dyan is there has to be a compelling reason enough for them to want to be persuaded. Minsan, at the onset, they get persuaded, pero hindi naman talaga matutuloy. Kasi mababaw. Dahil ang importante sa'yo,
foundation ng persuasion mo.
Ang importante sa'yo is not important to them, or hindi mo na i-communicate yung
or
importance or relevance.
Or just to get it over and done with, umuon na lang siya, pero walang ano, walang follow-through. Diba? Para tumigil ka lang dyan.
Just to end the conversation.
Yes, and I'm glad you mentioned that, Angel. Because when we're communicating, if you want to persuade strongly and effectively, you have to learn to listen.
Yun.
Oo. Lalo na pag may binibenta ka, you have to allow the other person, the buyer, to interrupt.
Oo.
Kasi minsan pag nagkukwento, that's also you allowing that person to feel indebted.
Oo.
Hindi ka kailangan mag-offer ng free, and then salita ka ng salita. By the time you start asking, so what do you think? Ang sagot ng buyer, I'll think about it, ha? But when you open yourself up by pausing, not interrupting, allowing that person to talk, he or she is starting to get heavily invested in you. Pagkatapos niya magkwento, ano ba yan? Ano ba yung binibenta mo? But normally, that's the situation.
Oo, mga ganun. Usually daw ang ginagawa ng mga nagpa-persuade, sinasabi nila, lagi daw you would always end your sentence with right? Why? 'Di ba? Yung mga ganun daw, parang merong kasunod, pwede siyang sumagot.
Yes.
Otherwise, laging close-ended yung ano mo, yung conversation.
Tama. And you give that person time and opportunity to express himself. So, maganda talaga na ma-practice natin yung friendly persuasion.
Mm-mm.
It's about conducting our life well, our relationships better, and our business more intelligent.
Parang it doesn't matter kung you're in a corporate setup, mm-mm, personal relationship mo, o yung mga ganyan tulad din, yung pag-shopping, yung mga ganyan.
Uh-oh.
So it boils down pa rin yung dapat marunong ka mag-balance ng friendly persuasion na sinasabi mo.
Oo. And when you have something to when you need something from anyone or any establishment, make sure that you have something more to give. May value kang maiko-contribute sa discussion, dun sa experience ng tao. And it's similar back to that pair of shoes in the store. Hindi mo lang nakita yung magandang shoes.
Mm-mm.
Nakita mo welcoming yung ambiance, attentive yung salesperson.
Kaya sabi nga nila, Michelle, I don't know if you will agree, ang buhay daw talaga is business transaction. Diba? Laging ganun. Laging, ano yung may offer mo sa akin, ano yung kaya kong ibigay sa'yo, at ano yung we could work together.
Yeah.
Always ganun daw.
Yeah. In the end, it's give and take. But from our end, we have to make sure that every time we give and we give value, we become more.
Uh-oh.
Para kahit that's the reality, life is a business transaction. In our engagements and our opportunities to persuade another person, we don't become transactional.
Mm-mm-mm.
Sincere ang approach pa rin natin, and the other person will simply buy into the message or the story and willingly get on our side.
Oo. Hindi yung mga masama yung balak mo.
Benta na.
Hindi masama yung balak.
Yung mga tao na ganun, no? Gagaling talaga nila sales talk.
Hindi mo alam, sinisales talk ka na pala nito.
Sinisales talk. Ano doon sa mga networking, di ba? Paano sila nakakaingan yun ng mga
kapit tayo.
Kapit
tayo.
Kapit tayo. Saan may gustong kumain?
Hindi naman din easy na maglabas ng pera, di ba? Say, 10,000, 8,000 pesos, di ba? Pero dami na kukuha ang tao.
Kaya we all,
important din, Ms. Sheila, yung hindi ka makaka-offend din. Kaya it's friendly. Kaya ang tag mo dyan, ang term mo is friendly. Persuasion.
Wag mong
kasi
ipilit.
Kasi merong iba, ha? It doesn't matter kung ano yung setting niya, corporate or whatever, or bibili ka lang. Nakaka-offend minsan, di ba?
Iba
parang
sa mga
natatamaan ka.
Sa mga, kunwari, sa isang store, sa mall, di ba? Yung tumitingin ka, tapos inaayos ng inaayos.
Ay, naku, ayoko yan.
Sige na nga, wag na, hindi na ako bibili.
Naiinis ako dyan. Parang antayin mo muna. Antayin mo muna makaalis ako, please.
Bibili ako, okay?
Yeah. Yung parang parang tinutulog ka, na mukhang magnanakaw to, ha? Mag-i-afford.
Tapos magtatanong ka, parang sinasabi niya na, hindi, mahal eh.
Wala kaming size eh.
Wala kaming size. Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
Kaya totoo yan.
Ay, may 2,000 po kasi yan eh. Yung mga ganun.
Kaya ba isang araw mo?
Unfortunately, sensibility is something that is very difficult to teach. It is what you learn over time through exposure to sensible and empathetic individuals who will teach you that as important as your concern is the consideration of the other person. So, kailangan yung store laging malinis kasi sabi ni boss, laging malinis.
Kailangan presentable.
But do you take for granted that there are clients who are there who would feel that you're shooing them away?
Yes.
Totoo yan.
At saka parang daanan mo, minap.
At saka parang importante din, ano, whatever you do, dapat iisipin mo lagi yung it would reflect to your character.
Yes.
It would say a lot about you. Hindi yung kung sino man yung reaction. Tama yun, ano?
Yeah. And as you put your message out there, kung ano man yung gagawin mo, and you evaluate that, tingnan mo in the long run, what kind of person you become. You will become. And that is starting now. So, kung medyo ilang ka dito sa ipopost mo, hindi ka comfortable sa sasabihin mo, or yung sa ipapagawa mo sa ibang tao, okay, think again. And hindi ka naman mauubusan ng ilang minuto para i-evaluate. Kasi any word that ends up being offensive, any action that ends up being abrasive,
would reflect about you, about your character.
And one moment of pain can cause you lifetime torture. Kasi nasira yung relationship, nawala yung sale, natanggal ka sa trabaho.
Hindi mo nabili yung gusto mo.
And you become traumatized instead of being enriched in the process. When we practice persuasion properly, we become not only more likable, but we become more appreciative of the environment that we're in. Kasi ang dami mong pwedeng ma-accomplish when you apply friendly persuasion.
Totoo. Yes. Sa talk shop ba, maraming kukuha ng course na ganyan sa inyo? Anong workshop, ano nila? Anong field?
Normally, the most corporations would get salesmanship, negotiation, assertiveness training. And if you evaluate their concerns and challenges, many of them boil down to in enhancing one's ability to persuade. Talagang alam mong magsalita pero may maniniwala ba?
Yun.
Alam mong alam mong mag-lead pero may susunod ba?
Totoo.
Yeah. So that's persuasion on a regular basis, and we need
power
that. Yes. So yung mga pinag-uusapan natin dito all throughout about self-care, personal effectiveness, that's very important. Kasi pag tingin mo sa sarili mo, sa salamin, at hindi ka convinced, nakapanipaniwala ka, it's very difficult to convince anyone, no matter how powerful your script. Umpisa mo sa sarili mo.
Totoo.
Because before you put the message out there, you have to be first convinced about it. So that every time you're talking, you're communicating to your team, you are one with the message that you're saying. Hindi nandito ka, tapos yung message mo nandun, hindi nila ma-connect.
A lot.
Oo. There's sensibility, there's integrity, and values in everything that you do and say.
Alright.
Thank you so much.
Talk
Thank
shop.
You.
Salamat. Talk Shop is... offering courses in salesmanship, negotiation, leadership, communication, and many of the segments in these workshops actually work on one's ability to persuade effectively. You can reach us at 0917-877-5588 or 8894-5588. And check us out on Facebook, Sheila Viesca, Talk Shop PH, our website, www.talkshop.ph.
Ayan.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Ang ating resident personal effectiveness coach and corporate communications guru.
Thank you.
Thank you.